So.
Okay. Şey, istediğiniz kadar gerçek hayattaki gibi.
Küfür edebilirsin de o.
Aranızda falan da konuşabilirsin.
Oh God. I said I cursed on küfür on video, tamam. Quoting dialogues. And I was almost hanged to the ceiling by the feet. I felt like Borat.
Küfür?
Küfür et diyor. Tamam. Ama eğer küfür edersen...
Türkçe mi?
Etmeyin.
Sonra asla cumhurbaşkanı olamaz.
I'll never be.
It's okay.
I'm just telling them they can't be president if they curse. They just choose.
Well, no, you can curse, you can smoke marijuana. You can have premarital sex. It's like, it's all about
okay. Okay, well, I can be.
How did you guys hear about Deniz for the first time?
Well, she called me and she told me that she was gonna make a film, and I have acted before in the movies of a director called Reha Erdem, and I called him immediately because I knew that they met before. So I called him and asked about her, and he told me you should definitely go and see her, and then I went to see her, and she was so pretty. Yeah.
Do you audition, or do you? How did you? Approach it?
No, the first discussion I was telling her about the project, and at that time I saw Elit with her elder sister, who by the time we shot the film had grown up too much, because Elit is a bit older than the characters in the film, so by the time we met I was praying for her not to grow up too much until we eventually would shoot the film. And we spoke a lot about the film, the content, a discussion, director, actor, actress discussion.
So she was first on?
She was definitely, I thought about her the whole time of the writing. And I think she had an impact on the fact that the five girls has these long hair, and we had this monster of femininity with very long hair, because I had the image of her. And then, Tugba is the only one that I proactively went to see at the airport and said, oh,
can you just at an airport? Or?
We got off the same plane and she went like in front of me a few times and was like, she had the temper and like the hair, and so in the beginning I was thinking, okay, a casting director is going to work on this and I'm not going to get out of my comfort zone. And then eventually I was like, okay, I have to go and talk to her.
Did you think she was crazy when she came up to you in the airport and talked about being a movie?
I searched her name after in the net, but she seemed nice, and I don't know, I trusted her. I don't remember, actually.
All of her.
And then the three other ones came to the casting. And the one big thing was not to be proactive, even if I've been with Tugba, because we were thinking if there's like a great young girl for the part, and then the family says no, like the fact that a girl for this age in Turkey came to the audition, it already said so much about her family and the fact that they could be open to the whole adventure. So
were any of you actresses before the three of you came to the casting call? Actresses before this, or
no? I just played in some of the TV shows,
but very little. Yeah.
Yes, I was very, very little, like 7 or 8.
So, what made you want to be an actress at 7 or 8 years old?
I don't know, but when I was 1 year old, my mom is always taking my photos, and she sent these photos to a magazine, and they told us that if she wants to be a model. My mom decided for me. And if she wanna be a model, we can take her pictures. And so I was like in this magazine like 5 years. And after that, I met with some guy, and he told me that there is some editions for a child TV shows. Do you wanna join? I said, okay. Because it sounds fun when you're a 5 year old, TV is looking like so cool for you. And then I started acting, and I have a little break for the school. And after years and years, my agency called me, and there's some kind of movie, you wanna go to audition? I said, okay. And after I met with Deniz.
So was TV cool?
I don't really remember. But I was a child. Everyone is so nice for me because I was a child. So it's, I remember like it's cool, but don't remember so.
Were you a more serious actress when you got into all this?
Sorry?
Were you more serious about acting as you?
Yeah, I was. When I was in primary school, my school was very supportive about like sports and about cultural stuff, and I was very interested in cinema and theater. And before I started to play in the films, I made the short film with my schoolmates, for example. And yeah, so I was very interested, and since I was very little, I was going to theaters and to cinemas all the time with my family. And
So three of you are non-actors?
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Before this? Mm-hmm. So was there any kind of training you did or any kind of preparation? Or?
Yes, of course. Well, I didn't ask during the audition process. We never asked them if they had acted or not acted. And it was more like we were looking into what for me were qualities that I thought I could direct. And then we had a few boot camps. We went through the script. We never really rehearsed completely the content of a scene, but around the scenes or situations which were very close to the scenes of the film. What happened between the scenes as well. A lot of discussions about the backstory. And then it was very playful and yeah.
Was it as fun being sisters as it looked?
I don't understand.
Was it as fun of being sisters as it looked in the film?
Yeah, it was really fun. It's still very fun to travel many places together.
How many so you were in Cannes together?
Yeah, we were in Cannes together in Toronto and in Sarajevo. We were not all together in every places, but we were like going to the places.
Yeah, sometimes we send someone.
Yeah. But we were together in Cannes, in Toronto, in Los Angeles, and New York.
In Odessa.
Yeah.
But not all together.
Sakhalin.
Yeah, in Russia I've been. In
You've
Italy.
Been to Venice.
In Venice.
Rome.
Yeah.
Berlin. Germany.
Berlin.
So you guys traveled much before all of this?
No. Yeah.
I did.
We've never been in, except Elit in United States. So we travel a lot with the film, and it's great to discover new places.
Actually, Cannes was my first travel.
And Doha as well.
So do you like Los Angeles?
Yeah, of course.
Of course. What's the best thing about Los Angeles? What have you found?
I think people are really friendly, and we're always doing some crazy things on the streets, and people like looking like, oh, yeah. And laughing so much, and we're like, yeah, okay.
Yeah, and the weather is so good.
Yeah, the weather is really good, and the sea is very beautiful also, the beach.
Have you done show business things? Have you done meetings and that kind of thing?
She did.
She did?
Yeah.
How'd that go? Good. And you've done a lot of shopping, I'm guessing?
Just a little bit.
Shopping?
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit?
Yeah.
Disneyland?
No.
No, but we want to go to the Universal Studios.
So you went, or you want to
go? Maybe tomorrow.
Yeah. So I'll have time to visit some museums tomorrow when they are visiting Universal Studios.
Have you been before?
Where?
Universal Studios?
No, I haven't, but I'm more interested in museums, actually.
You don't want to go down the Jurassic Park ride?
No, not that much.
That's for babies.
No, I'm not saying that, but I'm more interested in museums.
Well, it's an interesting age group to be traveling around with.
Yeah.
Because things seem like babyish, I guess. Like Disneyland.
Well, Elit is slightly much older than the other. But it's a bit like a family.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
So are you the mom while they're traveling, or are parents?
Well, we were discussing this earlier on. Yeah. And sometimes I'm the mom, sometimes I'm the elder sister. Sometimes a friend.
Yeah. Sometimes you're being smaller than us.
Sometimes like younger sister.
Sometimes they're much wiser than me.
And how was it on set? Was it interesting to be directed by Deniz?
It was. We were feeling very safe. So it was easy actually, because she was making us feel very comfortable, and like always supporting us and like always motivating us. And I was feeling like, I don't know, after I've worked with her, I felt like my limits has been expanded and now I trust myself more and that I feel like I can do more things and that I can be successful too. I'm believing myself more than before, yeah.
Was this stuff that was hard, scary to watch, scary to act for you?
No, not actually.
We had some difficulties while we were making the scene, I mean, like the fight scenes with the uncle and with grandma. It was a bit cold at the sea while we were playing, but now when we're thinking, I mean, now we don't really remember about like difficult stuff.
Goes away. Did you shoot in order or relatively in order?
As much as possible. Yeah. Some things, of course, had to move, and there was a lot of constraints about the house because we were building walls. And so, as the film went on, the house was changing, and so that was quite something we had to compose with. But as much as possible, we shot in order. Yeah.
Did you lose girls one by one, or?
We did, and then there was something about, you know. Later on in the film, you see the picture of the five girls when they're trying to escape. They're taking all that the things they will need for the escape, and they only take vital things, and they take the picture, and I love that. And while reading the script, I almost felt, always felt emotional at that point of the story. And the day the art director and his team came with the picture of the five girls with this very happy light and sunny atmosphere. We have been alone for a while with Doga and Günes, and it was darker and colder and harder. And we all of a sudden, like they showed the picture of the five girls, and I you know, we had the entire team, and I remember feeling so completely emotional, exactly as in the feeling of the film. Mm-hmm. Like it was long gone, and you were away, and we had missed you, and yeah. And being pregnant made me cry for everything. Like this, for everything.
So. Any of the rest of you cry over these things, or?
No, but it's contagious. If one of us laugh, the others do. If I cry, like everybody did. So see, she's starting to cry right now in front of you. She's a huge crier.
So is acting what you baby. When after you got assaulted at the airport? Was acting what you expected it to be?
No, I mean, I was very shy before, and I don't know what, I think it was more fun than I expected. I thought that it was going to be very strict, but it was very interesting, and we had a lot of fun.
And was you didn't remember acting at all, really, did you?
Me?
Yeah.
When
you went back to acting.
Yeah.
Did it feel like you were going back, or was it like you were starting again?
No, it's like it's so difficult with the TV and the movie, and I didn't have any experience about the movie. Right. And at the first, some of the people told me that, how is your director? Is she someone nice? Or I heard that they're so rude and so rules are rules. I was like, she seems fine. She seems nicely, and she is. And when we shooting, she always so nice and friendly to us, and because of she's our older sister and she's our friend, everything is going more easier.
It's true that probably there's a preconceived idea in Turkey that anybody who would be the boss would be like authoritative and you know, and probably they expected me to hit them or something.
Not really.
I never did I?
Never? Yeah. That one time.
So when you got to set, did you already kind of know what you were going to do through the movie? You'd already rehearsed enough that you guys had a sense of what the experience was going to be like?
Yeah, almost. Because we had like two boot camps before we started shooting. One in Istanbul and one in the place where we shot the film, and especially in the garden of our house. So in the first boot camp, while we were in Istanbul, we were like making exercises to get to know each other and like to feel more like sister. We were like giving our secrets to us and like hugging each other and stuff. And then when we get to the Inebolu, where we shot the film, while the house was getting ready, we were playing in the garden and we were like exercising the scenes and that kind of stuff, yeah.
And also like the first scene we shot was when we were playing in the sea. So it was like so natural, it didn't really feel like acting. We were just playing and laughing and someone with the camera was following us. So it was like, I really liked that it was the first scene because it was very fun and we started off very, you know, good.
The first time I saw the movie, I enjoyed that scene and thought it was fun, and then I found out what was going to happen, and it wasn't as fun anymore. The second time I saw it, it wasn't as adorable. It kind of became dangerous and scary a little bit.
Well, it's still fun. At the end, they escaped and they were fine.
So does the emotional subtext of all this stuff, are you working on that as actors, or some of you more than others? Concerning yourself, yeah. Or are you just doing the scenes that are in front of you? And
I don't understand.
Well, the way you work with the emotions inside the scene.
Are you thinking what's going to happen three scenes later? Something bad is going to happen?
Oh, you did. Maybe not necessarily three. You were like always very professional about, okay, where we are in the film and da-da-da. And I remember that. And we always... Of course, we always like
keeping in mind what was happened before
and
that
and what was
scene.
The emotion.
Yeah, what was the emotion? And yeah, I think what was, I mean, for me, the best thing that prepared me emotionally, that she was like, the way she was telling the stories. I mean, and I don't know. Sometimes she was it was making me laugh. Sometimes it was making me cry. And I was like recalling that kind of things. I feel like this. Yeah.
Also, when we were shooting the scene, like after Selma and Sonai got married, and we were like this, and like we have to cry, so like I thought about they're not gonna see each other again, but it didn't really feel like, because I knew that I was going to see them again, but when I thought about Lale and Noor and like they're not gonna see each other again, I started crying because I really could feel how they like. It's really natural, and it was like I really felt that I was Lale, so it was, I can really understand how she felt, so it was very emotional.
And we were all crying in this
scene.
And
she's crying
scene.
Now, like, yeah. You're gonna cry five times now, I have glasses. No, they were all crying. I was crying behind them. Everybody was crying.
Yeah, everybody and, like, was when, crying.
When
was
and when the scene is done, when we
yeah,
go back
crying.
To changing our costumes, we were still crying and hugging each other. Oh no!
Don't go.
So, do you enjoy Los Angeles even though you're not speaking English?
Los Angeles, San Francisco, I think it's a wonderful
incredible.
City.
She thinks it's wonderful?
Yeah.
So all of this doesn't, none of this is, it's all been equally good for you, even without English?
Senin için de diğerlerine kadar güzel oldu mu İngilizce konuşmadığım var. Of course. It's important to feel, and I feel it.
So what was Cannes like for all of you? It's obviously it was a fun place to go to, but here you go, and there are all these people in this room waiting to watch you. Was that freaky?
Emotional.
It was very emotional.
Emotional.
It was exciting because it was the first time that we saw the movie.
Yeah.
And it was our first travel.
And it was our first travel, and we didn't see each other
so long.
For so long time.
That's for a long time.
Yeah.
And when we were there, we. After seeing the movie, we were all
crying
again.
Yeah.
It was very exciting and emotional.
Yeah. We started crying and we say, okay, now it's time to stop. And when we turn our backs, people are still crying and clapping us. And we said, oh my God, we start crying again. Like it takes 20 minutes.
It's true, there was something extremely exuberant during that first screening. And even the morning, the film had been screened at 9 o'clock. And when we came into the theater, it was very, very emotional. And that afternoon when we were in the screening, it was, I remember a lot of blood, sweat, tears.
Yeah.
No, yeah, I remember like that. I don't know for you.
And the
but.
Whole team was there.
Yeah.
We were all together, the whole equipe. And it was great because it was just like she said it was the first time that we were seeing each other again after the shootings. So it was very beautiful.
Did any, were any of you, was it hard to watch yourselves act?
No. It was fun, yeah.
Seeing yourselves giant with giant heads and bodies? Just
no, pleasurable. They giggled the whole time,
actually.
They giggled and they talked the whole time. So yeah, they're boisterous.
So and you were the people you don't want to be sitting behind in the movie theater.
Günes was next to me. And no, but she has a contagious laugh. So maybe like the success of the film comes from the fact that they, you know, they were pulling the audience to laugh and then...
And did you feel the love of all those people? I mean, is that...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were laughing with us, actually. I mean, we were not the only ones who were laughing. They were laughing with us. They were crying during the film. And it was very, very emotional.
We feel all the emotions.
Yeah, they clapped for 10 minutes after the film.
No, during the film.
And yeah, during the film when the woman was breaking the electric. Like they were supporting us and they were on our side and they were defending us. It was great.
Rooting for the girls.
Yeah.
And did you go to other screenings or is that the only screening you went to?
Yeah, we've been in the... Yeah.
So is it the same every time? Does it feel like...
It changed, actually. It changed from culture to culture when people are laughing to the scenes. For example, in Turkey, I don't remember, but I've noticed that they have laughed in a part of the film that I never heard any laughter before in other parts. So it changed through the parts of the country.
I remember watching it like for the fourth time in Turkey. I was with Doga, and like I remember I cried after the movie, like it doesn't matter if it's like the 10th time or 20th time, because like you can, I mean, you don't have to cry because of what happens in the movie, you just, you know, remember your memories with the girls and everything, so that's emotional too, so yeah.
And it's just a movie for us. We feel everything with this movie and we live everything with this movie, so it's, we have a so big background and it's really emotional thing too.
They actually do remakes of the scenes with
Iceland. Yeah, that's true.
All the time.
It should be on the DVD extras.
Yeah, definitely.
For the movie. They're like the Wolf Pack. There's a movie about some brothers who were not allowed to leave their house in New York City for years. And they made movies as a way of relieving their boredom. And they'd remake famous movies like Rocky or, you know, Raging Bull or God knows what, Dracula. Mm. So you guys can be the girl version, the sister version.
Yeah.
So have any of you gone to work more since this? Have you done other movies, any of you?
Not yet.
Are you anxious to? Or is it kind of such a perfect experience that you don't want to mess it up?
No.
I'm willing to, actually.
And of course, I want to, you know, make other movies too, but I mean, I will always remember this, and I really wanted to be like this one, to be like this emotional and to go like somewhere. And it's very different when you work with people you love. So I really, you know, expect that to happen, like with other movies too. So, you know,
it's gonna be rough.
I have expectations.
So are you, have you, did you expect any of that when you started?
No.
Did you have any like preconceived notion of what it was gonna be like when you signed on?
Actually, I didn't think it would be this fun and like we would be this close, because like when I met them for the first time, I wasn't like this. I was more shy, and I was like, we had this exercise when we were hugging each other and looking in each other's eyes, and it was like not that comfortable because, you know, I mean, I just saw them, so it was kind of weird, but then, you know, I got used to it, and now we're hugging all the time.
So. You're like a litter of kittens.
Yeah.
In the beginning, they were talking to each other only. They were not talking to us that much.
Actually, they were texting.
Yeah.
They were so strange. We sat around
when
the same table.
When they sit on each other, like, they were always
so
texting.
Shy. Yeah.
Yeah, there was like cakes on the table, and, you know, we can just take them. So I was texting her like, okay, we're going to take that when I say three. One, two, three. Then we look at each other, okay.
Were you gossiping about us?
In the beginning, I was wondering what they were doing. and they were texting each other around the table. It was so crazy.
I remember that they're gossiping about us because I knew when we shoot the match scene, she takes my picture or she and send it to the other and says, she's here.
Oh, really?
Yes. And I'm like, it's so hot. That's fake.
So are there any other odd pairings or groupings in the group? Or
odd just... pairings?
And now?
Well, then, now, did you, were there any other dyads or triads? Or?
Yeah, it means like, were there conflicts and divisions and like someone we bullied and...
Are there cliques?
No.
No.
No.
Just the texting sisters.
Yeah, but that changed as
Yeah,
well.
That changed.
You stopped texting each other?
No.
Yeah, they are still texting to each other, and we are texting to each other too, but they are not talking, I mean, they are talking to us right
now. Yeah.
We
have just texting each other.
And we exchange a lot of messages.
I assume you're texting under the table right now, right?
Yeah,
true.
Do you want to put
my No.
Shake your hand.
So was the experience, so did anybody else have an experience where it was very different making the movie than what you thought it was going to be when you signed on to do it?
Different.
Did you expect anything? Did you have like any preconceived ideas of what the shooting would be? No, I remember the girls being super impatient, and at some point the shooting was postponed, and we were doing the boot camp in Istanbul with Bahar giving you all those tools, and yeah, it was like, come on, let's do this. You know, it was more like that was the mood.
And by the end, they were just cool and. Another day
by the
set,
end, it was yeah, and upset when they left the set.
Yeah.
Well, it sounds like you wanted to create a family.
Yes.
That was your way of making a movie.
Definitely. Yeah.
So in some ways, you were doing like a documentary that happened to be have a script.
Well, you need to. It's such a great adventure to make films. That's true. It's one of the greatest things we can live together as well. It's such a big thing.
And did the adults who were, the two of them were actors, right?
You mean like the other people?
No, well, the
apart from me.
The uncle and the grandmother were regular actors, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So was it strange for them, or did they just dive right in? And
no, because actors are like, whatever age they are so playful as well. Like, the grandmother, I love the way she would just engage in the scene in a very, very, she's very childish, like so professional, but the way she gets into the scene, it's very, very playful. She looks like a child on the playground, and it's great, and she has a great imagination, and I love that dimension of her.
We still call her grandma. Like, when we see her, we don't say like,
Nihai.
Yeah, we say, look, our grandma's coming. it's like a family.
And will this be your method, do you think, in terms of how you approach making films?
Well, yeah, there's some ground rules of probably a frame of what I would do with actors all the time. I know that in the dialogue with actors, and as soon as I meet someone I'd like to work with, I know that there's like... With actors, you can say everything, and it's personal and intimate immediately, and that's the rule for me. So it engages a certain type of relation, and plus you have to be the first one to put your feet in the cold water and just do it. So, because then you're going to compose with private things, and so there's that. But then, of course, it's very different when you have in a group like this one where most had never acted before, it's... Yeah, you have to create a whole, a whole system of way you're going to work and everything.
And every person has a different experience. Yeah. And everything.
But for example, with Aybek and Nihal, like it's immediate. We sat down and we spoke before, but we didn't like train or boot camp or, and they just come and do it. But in a very, Iberg too, he feels like he's so great and you always have that child dimension in him as well. And then there was some actors I couldn't like, of course, like with very, very secondary parts, I couldn't like always have huge discussions of backstory, like, do you remember that issue?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So do you all live in the same town now?
We live in Istanbul. Tugba lives in Paris, and Deniz lives in Paris too.
So will you have a reunion in a year? Because eventually you have to stop meeting like this, right?
We spoke about this just before.
Yeah.
Like earlier today.
So will you have an annual gathering, or?
We'll gather, but
we'll
yeah,
see. We'll see what will happen.
It could be in Paris.
Yeah, of course. Maybe we can make another movie together. I want to be a director too. Maybe they can be my actresses in the future also.
Mustanger. More Mustang.
Mustang Junior.
Mustang the later years. It could all come together. Well, thank you guys for coming out and chatting.
Thank you.
I think she had a name for it. What was it? Sorry.
Oh, she has a title, a Turkish title for the next film. It's like a specific type of
horse.
Person of a horse.
Yeah.
Ama şey yani.
Ama hayır, at.
Okay.
Well, the translation going, right?
No, because they're not exactly okay with what it can mean. Like it has a double meaning, the word. Anyway,
that's a good thing.
It's a horse.
Much like your title, this movie now has a double meaning.
Yeah.
Good way. Yeah. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.